Hello, everyone. My name is Pauline Haycock, and I am the celebrant at Reynars Funeral Home. And before we start, I just have a few announcements. And the first is, if you have a cell phone, would you please be so kind as to turn off your ringer? You don't want to be that guy. Secondly, once the family is seated, there may be some extra seating a little bit closer to the front for those of you that are standing. Otherwise, we can make our way to the bleachers as well once everybody is in and sitting down. Interment will be at a later time, and so you're invited to stay for refreshments following the service. And make sure that you check out the memorial tables if you didn't have a chance to do that on your way in. I know it was kind of crowded and busy. So at this time, I'd like to ask you to please rise as the family comes to join us. Even though it's only church where we were going. Now, Sunday mornings I just sleep in. It's like I buried my faith with you. I'm screaming at the God I don't know if I believe in. Cause I don't know what else I can do. I'm still holding on ever. Now you're in the stars and 6 feet's never felt so digging through your old birthday letters. A crumpled 20 still in the box. Left the rest in peace. I'm still holding, holding, holding on. I'm still holding, holding, holding on. I'm still holding, holding, still holding on. I'm still holding, still holding on. I'm still holding on to everything. Dead and gone. I don't wanna say goodbye, cause this one means forever. Now you're in the stars, never felt so far. Here I am alone between the heavens and the embers. Oh, different reasons you took the best of my heart. Love the rest in peace. The funeral home staff will help you find seats in the balcony if you choose to do that. Well, on behalf of Ryeley Palfi's family, I would like to thank each and every one of you for your attendance here today. Those of you inside this building and those of you that have joined us via the live stream. Your kind words and your generosity have not gone unnoticed, and they are genuinely appreciated. So many people have reached out to the family, and they are ever so grateful for all of that. So, at this time, we're going to open prayer. I ask that you would please bow with me. Lord, you know that this has been a difficult, tragic week for this family and all of these friends. And I just ask, Lord, that the words spoken during the service today would be a comfort to them, We thank you for the years that Ryeley had and how he touched the lives of those here today and countless people around the world. Please go with us now during this time as we remember him and we celebrate his life. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. Well, family, when you woke up, turned off your alarm and looked at the time and started your day on June 8th, I am certain that you were not thinking about planning a funeral. It wasn't even on your radar. And as the day went along, I'm sure you were caught up in your everyday routine, never expecting that later that night you would receive a phone call or a knock on your door to inform you that your lives had tragically changed. And from the moment that you heard the news, your lives have been turned upside down. Would it be fair to say that you feel like you've been shaken like a protein drink? Yeah. That you've been running like you're on a treadmill? No doubt about it. Well, now it's time to stop. And for a few brief moments, we're going to put aside our responsibilities, our worries, and our sorrow, and we're going to focus on celebrating the life of Ryeley Scott Palfi, beloved son, brother, nephew, friend, mentor, and motivator. And it seems ironic to use the word celebrate, doesn't it? Celebrating is the last thing that we feel like doing when someone we love passes away. No matter the circumstances surrounding the passing of our loved one, each family member, friend, and acquaintance has an inborn need to honor, respect, and remember the one who has died. And that has been played out over and over again with the passing of Ryeley. Not only people from the community, this community, but people from around the world have reached out to Ryeley's family to offer condolences and stories of how he has touched their lives. Family, you have taken the time to create a meaningful service for Ryeley. A service that reflects who he was and who he was becoming. And I hope that it helps you to take the first step down the path of your healing journey. Now, the one thing that is said in every news article that I have read, every conversation I have had or overheard about Ryeley's passing, and what is in the hearts and minds of each one celebrating his life today, is his age. I've heard things like, he was so young, he had so much to live for, what a promising future he had. Well, Alexander Solzhenitsyn, a Russian novelist and activist who had seen his share of persecution and death over his lifetime, wisely said, "Some are bound to die young. By dying young, a person stays young in people's memory. If he burns brightly before he dies, his brightness shines for all time." I think Ryeley burned brightly, no doubt about it. Family, although Ryeley was approaching his 20th birthday, stepping out into adulthood, is it fair to say that you still saw him as your fun-loving son? Your annoying brother? Where are those siblings? Your sweet grandchild or your nephew? Your memories of him will be full of life, of health, of youthful energy and hopefulness. You may never get over his passing, but those memories will help you get through it. So portrait photographer Ann Geddes is quoted as saying, "Any man can be a father, but it takes someone special to be a dad." Well, today Ryeley's dad, Rick Palfi, is going to do a very difficult job. With the help of his friend Reed Lepine, he is going to honor his son by sharing the eulogy with us. So Rick and Reed, please come and tell us Ryeley's story.
I fucking love you, buddy. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Rick Palfi, Ryeley's father. His mother, Katrina, is here in the front row. We are his biggest fans.
I'm Reed Lepine, and I'm Rick's best friend and brother. I'm one of Ryeley's other father figures in life and friend.
Ryeley Scott Palfi, born July 16, 2002, at 12:17 a.m. at 7 pounds, 3 ounces, and 21 inches long in Dawson Creek, B.C., Canada, where he called at home his entire life. Brennan was our firstborn child. 2 years later, along came Ryeley. 3 years later, he became an older brother with his sister, Cameron. She went. He became another brother to Cash in 2012 and then his little baby sister, Gracie, in 2017. His mom had a very long, hard labor. And he came into this world with an incredible energy and continued to be strong-willed from the day he was born. He was the most caring, gentle, kind human being. His mom says, ever since he was born, I knew he was different. He had such a big heart, soul of kindness and selflessness for others and animals. He was born with a mission. As a child, he excelled at everything he did. He was smart and athletic at school sports. He was always winning awards. I taught the boys how to do backflips and front flips on the trampoline and on the ground at a very young age, 5, 6 years old. This was always one of his signature moves, as you know. At 4 years old, he joined his brother Brennan and myself in racing motocross. He learned very quickly how to ride and to win races. We traveled all over Western Canada. He went on to win many races and championships. He truly was unstoppable. In 2010, I was in a devastating motocross accident, which put me in a coma. And at the same time, both boys were in casts from their crashes. And it was at this time that their mother, Katrina, devastated by the injuries, decided that she didn't want to see any of this us in this situation again. Therefore, we stopped racing. This is where we decided to get the boys into hockey instead. Much safer sport, right? Ryeley once again quickly excelled. He was always watching his brother on the ice play a couple leagues ahead of him, cheering him on in the stands. He loved hockey. He put his heart and soul into it. He was a team leader and was always there to back his team up when they needed it most. He would go out in an important game and play so hard. Sometimes sending them out of the game injured, he would take them into the boards a little harder than he initially wanted to. He played hard and I felt bad any time he went into the boards with them because I knew they were going to probably get injured. He was always the first to help pick the other player up off the ice so and make sure that they were okay. Growing up, Brennan and Ryeley were fortunate to be close with several other families, creating a large group of boys that were their brothers. Their poor little sister had to endure years of dealing with all of the boys. Boating all summer and water sports was an adventure every time. The winter was hockey, snowboarding, and skiing. We had many boys' trips together with the kids and had so many memories. He was always high energy. He made sure people were always laughing and having a good time, mainly from his annoying little laugh. I'm sorry, where did I go here? Right here. In 2014, I took a major interest and started training for a bodybuilding show. I would bring Ryeley to the gym with me, and I taught him proper lifting with some light weights, and he loved every minute of it. His mom bought him a membership, and he never looked back. I was 40, he was 12. We competed in 2015, and watching the bodybuilders on stage, he decided that's what he wants to do for the rest of his life. He took it to an entirely different level. He read books on Arnold Schwarzenegger, learned proper nutrition and new lifting techniques. He started to teach me and many around him. This is where he realized he could make a career out of this. The stage was set. In 2018, Ryeley and I hired my coach, Dane McCoo, to assist Ryeley with his training. A month before his first show, I reached out to Marcus Callis, owner of Magnum. He was so blown away by him that he immediately signed a contract to become Magnum's youngest athlete. I had the honor of standing on stage with him that May of 18 in Fort St. John, BC, with my wife, Chanel. With multiple awards, he truly cleaned house that day. At 15 years old, he did incredible. There's rarely been someone that age compete, if ever, at all. The following month, he went into the Vancouver Showdown, and he got to watch all the pro bodybuilders and compete as well. He did amazing considering his youth. He knew that he was determined enough to become a champion. He got to meet his idol, Chris Bumstead. C-Bum, they call him. He is a world champion of the classic physique division. And Ryeley's goal was to one day step on stage and whoop his ass. His passion for the sport excelled him to learn to push himself to be the best in the world. He already defeated Chris in his mind. He never gave up. Even when he was down, he was always pushing hard. He was going to be the best, and there was absolutely no stopping him. He had many jobs, but was never satisfied. He wanted the bodybuilding to be his career. He was focused on the gym and his social media, where he helped thousands, if not millions, get over obstacles in their lives. This was his true mission, to help others in pain, to help others achieve their highest goals. He was incredible at it. He had a gift. His mom says, Ryeley just wanted to save the world one person at a time. At just 18, he moved to Edmonton to further pursue his career in fitness. He was there with his girlfriend, Megan. Her family showed up here today all the way from Edmonton. They lived there for several months. But he felt the pull to come home. He went to work to make some money so he could further his gym and social media platform. He moved in with his brother. This is where he had lived since midwinter, and Brennan says he still hasn't done the effing dishes. He worked in the oil patch the last few months and saved up for the street bike that he had to have so bad. Oh, the street bike. Of course, against our wishes. He assured us that he would be careful, and I feared for this so bad. He only had the bike a couple of days. Tragically, these were his final days on Earth. He was in a terrible accident that ended his young, beautiful life. He was driving on his way to the gym really fast, as if he already knew he was heading to heaven. He wanted to get there fast, and he didn't want to feel a thing. On the way there, he didn't feel a thing. He had a mission. He felt no pain. Yet he left us all to feel the pain for him. But he left us with so much more. I wear your ring now on my necklace close to my heart. It was on his hand that day. You will always be close to my heart until we meet again, and we will. I'll be tougher than you, though. And bigger. I would just like to take a minute. We can just close our eyes and think of Ryeley, how you remembered him. This pain is exactly how you'd imagine it, times a million. Cameron would like to share a cute little story. I remember this. I remember how you used to torture me with your farts. You and Brennan would always find it funny to bug me and gang up on me. They got the best humor out of it as they saw me scream and struggle. So one day they thought it would be so awesome if they set up their GoPro and both gang up on me while we're on a trampoline. It was very unfair. Brennan would straddle me down by all four limbs, and Ryeley would squat down so far and sit on my face, he would just let it rip. The famous beef stew. Then it would still stay there until the smell went away. They found it was so funny as I would scream in horror of the stench. Mom had said that she would always be in the kitchen window looking and watching us while laughing at me. I was helpless and I was pretty much dead from the fart. He was always doing prankster stuff to make people laugh, and he was great at it. Brennan remembers how Ryeley used to make such funny faces all the time and make really annoying sounds. He drove me nuts. When I decided to let him move in with me, I was concerned that I might not get paid on time, or perhaps even ever at all. But I didn't care. I wanted to help him too. I really loved when I would come home from work and smell his weed from his bong. It drove me nuts. It also really sucked trying to find a phone cord because he had mine and pretty sure he had Dad's too. I also knew that I could depend on him though if I ever needed his help. And I'm also pretty sure he would have my back if I was ever in a bad situation. He was my young bodyguard. This is a story that I wrote. You see, we cry on this side of heaven. But our son wouldn't like that. He's not crying. He's okay, and he sent me messages today. The past few mornings I've been waking up, and the words I hear are, "Today is not for me, it's actually for you." You see, he's okay. We have a breath and a heartbeat, and we can't take that for granted. Our son was fine one moment and he was gone, the blink of an eye. And we now have a moment to think and ask questions. There are no answers, only more questions. Hug your family. Hug them as if you will never get to hug them again. And say, "I love you," and say it so much that the other person can't stop saying it back. Seriously, annoy them with it. Don't give up. People here know that I'm annoying and I ramble. That's why I had to write this down. Hug your family. We are writing this for you, son, but you probably want it wrote your way and your way only. We were training together, and you would tell me, "Dad, we need to do it this way." And I said, "You don't know what you're doing, son. It's got to be this way." You definitely knew right what you were doing, and you taught me so many things. You knew all along. You knew things I never even dreamed of knowing. I seemed to think I had it all figured out, and you would blow my mind with your information. blow my mind. When I wanted to charge my phone, I would ask you where the cord is. I don't know, Dad. The million-dollar phone chargers. They always went missing. I would find it right where you left it. You borrowed it, but you borrowed it like the time that you had on this planet. I keep messaging you, hoping to see a reply. And I want to see you reply in the positive way that you normally did. Your uplifting messages that I loved so much when you weren't mouthing me off. I received messages the other day from you through some friends. You said, Dad, stop crying. I want you to be strong. Don't be so sensitive. Everything will be fine. You're right, though. I am sensitive. Sensitive to the little things in life. Little things like, hey, son, how are you today? A few hundred days later, a response from Ryeley. Oh, I'm pretty good, Dad, just grinding away. Thanks for the response, son. Hope you're not working too hard, Dad. You are sensitive, too. We share that trait. I tear up at sad cartoons, for crying out loud. There's some really sad ones out there. You love your animals so much. You've always had so much love to give. You were so busy following your dream that I almost forgot that we taught that to you. I always told you, do what you love. Follow your passion, and the success will follow. Don't let money drive you. You were doing exactly that. That's why you're always so goddamn broke. The one thing I taught you is no matter what people think, to do your thing. Don't stop doing it and push harder than you ever, ever have. Be better tomorrow than you are today at this moment. Always achieve to be better. You texted me that you were so proud that you bought this new bike. I'm scared. I'm so scared. I hate that bike. But when I look back through my life, I had that same bike. And I was pretty much the same age. And I did these things that scared my parents too. I understand how my parents felt. Your journey in life was to push me to be a better person. And your journey is important to you. You have a life and direction that nobody understands. You have grown and you are a huge, huge influence. A warrior and a true fighter. Your hopes and dreams have been put forth by the power of your thoughts. You have discovered peace, love, and prosperity that I hadn't even fully realized it. I realize it now. His mom says he completed his mission. He has become more than he could have ever dreamed of becoming. XOXO, I'm so very proud of you, my baby. Love, Mom. Katrina found so many notes in her keepsakes. He would scribble things like who knows what he was scribbling, fart dust or something, and she would save it. It would be in her keepsakes. She found a note to him from when, I don't know how old was he, grade 4. To my wonderful mommy, you are the best mom ever. You are sad sometimes, and I love you so much, and when you pass away, I will never forget you or Dad, and sometimes me, and Brennan and Cameron, and Dad are very happy with what we have. At school, we are having fun, and you're at home watching the soaps, and we are watching our things and playing our games. I love you, Mom. Such a sweet boy. He always did these things. I've received thousands of messages on social media. I can't get through anywhere near any of them. Some of them I really resonated with. I had no idea that he was influencing people around the world at every corner you can imagine. My boy. Had no idea. Carl writes me, I'm so sorry for your loss, Rick. Words can't describe how much your son impacted my life. I've had a rough life. Lost my best friend when I was 12. Turned me inside out, to say the least. He was my mentor and my idol. Boom, 1 year later, I found your son on Instagram and he changed everything. He saved me truly. I tried ending my life 3 times before that. And when I found him on here, it completely changed the way I thought about life. I saw a bit of my old buddy in Ryeley, and I guess I feel like I lost my buddy twice. Ryeley and I just started working together a couple months back, and he was going to make me great, and with his coaching, I could because your son was and will always be one of a kind, and I don't think I'll ever meet someone like him again. He was truly too good for this world. To end it all here, bro, just know that I will always stick up to you guys like my own family, because I am truly in debt to your son, and I will never be able to pay him back for the things that he taught me. Blessings from Denmark. Pietro, I can't find the right words. While there is no right words to describe the feelings I got about what happened, I can't imagine yours. You're strong, Rick, you and your family. Words definitely can't express my sorrow for your loss. Now I'm only looking forward to carry on his inspiring mindset, passion, and his legacy. He gave us so much of these for real. That also means that you and your wife have been the best dedicated parents. Roots do matter. If he was such a wonderful human being, then so are you. It's like a rule. We, our children, sons, we took everything from our parents, right? I hope he rests in peace, pumping iron, even in heaven. Iron or iron? I can never understand how to pronounce it. Never, ever stop being resilient. Sorry for my bad English, by the way. My deepest sympathies, Rick. Sending you all big, strong, heartfelt hug from Italy. Your son was a huge inspiration for me. Ryeley was a reason I started working out. He inspired a lot of people, including me. Prayers from Germany. Rest in peace, Ryeley. Thousands of these, and they keep pouring in. I have one story that it's gonna be as quick as I can make it with my rambling. A funny thing about Ryeley, I remember we were racing motocross, and he's little, 8 years old. We were at the Beaver Lodge motocross track, and it was one of his earlier races. Well, he was 8, he'd been racing for a few years, but he got a new bike. He was going out on the track, and it was practice, so I told him, son, you don't know the track, we've walked it, you haven't rode it, just take it easy on the first lap. Yeah, you bet, Dad, no problem, we got this. He goes out there, gate drops. Well, he thinks it's a race. He comes around the first corner, and there's a double jump there. All the kids just roll over it. He just, wide open. He nailed that thing, and he cased it with his arms in the air, and he landed on the gas tank with his balls. We went running, and he was off the side of the jump screaming and crying in pain. Dad, my balls. I'm like, it's okay, son, are you okay? He's like, no, my balls. So I got him up, I said, you're fine, get on the bike, you'll finish. He goes around, finishes a lap barely, comes off crying, there's blood. There's blood down to that. I'm like, oh, shit. So I look, yeah, well, he had a little bit of an injury there. Tore some of his wiener off that day, as he put it. Well, a couple weeks, we go to the hospital, and they put a little bandage over him, and we had to, that was fun, change his little bandaging on his wiener every couple, 3 times a day. It was so small at that time. Baby, you were little. And about 2 weeks later, he's like, Dad, I gotta tell you something. And I'm like, what? What now? I gotta show you something. He goes to the bathroom, and he pees, and it's like spraying all over the place. And I'm like, you know what that means, son. Off to surgery we go for a circumcision. He comes out of surgery screaming. I'll never forget, he'd come out of there screaming from the pain. My balls. we go to race that next weekend, and he kicks ass. Like, he was way out front. The kids that raced with him, a bunch of them are here, so they all know. He gets off, and at the end of the awards, he gets a trophy, and he's like, I'd like to thank my sponsors, my mom and dad, Monster Energy, Pro Circuit, Kawasaki, Yamaha, KTM, and I'm also really thankful because of my new titanium wiener. It made me lighter, and it made me faster. He was always so funny.
And he wanted to show all the boys it, too.
Yeah.
And my twins wanted to see it, too.
Everybody got to see Ryeley naked.
Yes, that's guaranteed we've seen that.
Did Reed want to say a story? You got a pretty funny one there.
Finish that. Or?
I'll story and then I'll send that on.
Well, I got lots of stories about Ryeley. I don't even know where. I had a million to talk about. They're not always funny because he picked on me as much as I picked on him, so he's probably got a lot of funny stories about me. One thing about Ryeley, when he did stay with us, he would never wear clothes. He'd wear these skimpy little underwear, and I'd get jealous because I didn't want my wife to see his body, and then she see my body. So I'd be like, Ryeley, put some effing clothes on, because this is kind of embarrassing. Lots of things with Ryeley. He worked with me. He loved his phone. We battled about the phone all the time. Get off your phone. And then I'd go on Instagram, and I'd be on Instagram putting stuff on. So we had lots of good times together. I miss him more than anything. And just that's all I got to say, guys.
Thank you for all being here. I feel like I could go on forever. We want to thank you for all the love and support you have shown us all, the encouragement for all sharing this special time with us. There is so much love in here and around the world. The sacrifices made for our family and our friends has put us on our knees. We want to thank the medical team that fought so hard to save you, the doctor that did everything he could. Ryeley, you have left this planet in physical form, but you are very much here with us in spirit. This, I know, and I don't even question it. I can feel you everywhere. You're strong. You're so powerful. I had to tell you to back off of me yesterday. You were bear hugging me so hard I couldn't breathe. Your energy is larger than life, and we are all blessed to still have you here with us in spiritual form. I can still hold you every single day. We can say this, whether he is here with me or he is with someone else helping them, it doesn't matter. He is here with all of us for eternity. On behalf of our son, Ryeley Palfi, we express our sincere gratitude for attending this very special day. It means the world to all of our family and friends. I have a little tribute that I would like to do. I'm going to warn you, you might want to plug your ears. Can I get somebody to help me with my bike? Can somebody bring me my bike? Actually, I'll go get it.
Okay, I'm going to sit down. What?
Thank you.
Wow. Thanks, gentlemen. We got a song. Can we have that song, please?
When I get where I'm going, on the far side of the sky, the first thing that I'm gonna do is spread my wings and fly. I'm gonna land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane, where I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. Gonna walk with my granddaddy, and he'll match me step for step. And I'll tell him how I've missed him every minute since he left. And then I'll hug his neck. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. So much pain and so much dark, this world we stumble through, all these questions I can't answer, and so much work to do. But when I get where I'm going, and I see my Maker's face, I'll stand forever in the light of His amazing grace.
Well, it's a complete understatement to say that losing someone dear to you is hard. But losing that loved one unexpectedly can challenge you emotionally, physically, and mentally in ways that you never expected. You're shocked and grieving and trying to make sense of it all. And more often than not, we are filled with regrets. Now, the Merriam-Webster's Dictionary defines regret as sadness or disappointment caused especially by something beyond a person's control. And often we express our regrets by saying, why didn't I? I should have said. And those regrets, those statements plague us as they run through our minds over and over again. It's like unintentionally punching yourself in the face while you're trying to pull up your comforter at night. You hurt yourself while trying to comfort yourself. Regrets are kind of like earworms. Have you ever heard of earworms? They're not an insect. They are those unrelenting tunes and songs that you can't get out of your head. Songs like, "If I Had $1 Million." You know what I'm talking about. In fact, at the end of the service today, we're going to hear one that Ryeley loved. So wait for it. Just for Mom. They say that the only way to rid yourself of the insidious infestation is to replace it with another tune. It's called your cleaner song. New words in a fresh tune can drown out or get rid of the old. So I'd like to encourage you, as Ryeley's family and friends, to keep that in mind when your grief gets too much to bear. Instead of thinking, "He'll never get to," or "I wish," try asking yourself, "Remember when?" Can we please have the PowerPoint?
Claimed you so proud and openly, Please don't stop the music. Please don't stop the music. Music, 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 music,
music. Nice job, family. A lot of pictures. A lot of memories. When I meet with the family to plan a celebration of life, I ask a lot of questions that are designed to help me get to know and help the family paint a picture of their loved one so that I can make sure that the service, my part of the service, is all about them. And as you've seen, today was to be a reflection of every part of Ryeley's life. From the time he was a little boy attending school and racing on the local motocross track until his present-day ventures into bodybuilding world. Well, one of the reasons that we're here in the Dawson Creek Kin Arena because over the years, Ryeley spent a lot of time here. You can see the pictures of hockey. It's a reflection of his childhood. And so I'd like to close our time together with a hockey story. And the information that I'm sharing with you comes from the Canadian Encyclopedia. On December 30th, 1986, the WHL Swift Current Broncos hockey team were in a bus on their way to Regina to play the Regina Pats. The bus hit a patch of ice, slid off the overpass, hit an embankment, went airborne, and then flipped on its side, sliding 100 meters before coming to rest in a ditch. Four players were killed that night in the crash. And in their memory, their jersey numbers were retired by the team. The rest of the team, led by future NHL star Joe Sakic, played out the season despite the tragedy. It's important to note that future NHLer Sheldon Kennedy was also a member of that team. Now, fast forward 31 years and a few months to April 6, 2018, a day that most of us here could probably easily remember. When the SJHL Humboldt Broncos hockey team was struck by a transport truck, killing 16 of the passengers, 10 of whom were the players, while 13 others were injured. It's not a surprise that during that time, the Swift Current Broncos expressed their condolences to the Humboldt Broncos organization and a group of survivors from the Swift Current team that crash, led by Sheldon Kennedy, went to Humboldt to support the team, their families, and the community. There's two points I want to make about this story. First, to you, Ryeley's family. Let others support you at this difficult time. Just as Sheldon Kennedy and his former teammates supported the Humboldt families, there are people who will walk the road that you find yourself on and can help carry the burden that you must now bear. When Sean Brandow, the Broncos team pastor, addressed the grieving town of Humboldt, he asked, "Why did this happen?" And then he said to the grieving families, "I would love to stand up here as your spiritual leader and say I have all the answers, but I don't. I don't know why. I just want you to know that we hurt with you." Family, each one here today is so very, very sorry for your loss. Your community hurts with you. Now, secondly, to all who grieve the passing of Ryeley, this is the message that his family has for you. They believe that Ryeley would want you to continue on. Joe Sakic, Sheldon Kennedy, and the Swift Current team did just that after their crash. They honored their fallen teammates by playing the season out. Ryeley would want you to play your season out, to continue to be the best that you can be, to make a difference in the life of others, to strive to reach your goals. Don't stop living. I think it would be appropriate to end our time together with a quote from Arnold Schwarzenegger. A quote that will challenge you to keep on keeping on, just as Ryeley would have wanted you to. Mr. Schwarzenegger said, "Strength does not come from winning. Your struggles develop your strengths. When you go through hardships and decide not to surrender, that is strength. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise for Ryeley? Your song, Mom.
Can I, ooh. A long, long time ago, there was a volcano living all alone in the middle of the sea. He sat high above his bed, watching all the couples play and wishing that he had someone too. And from his lover came this song of hope that he sang out loud every day for years and years. I have a dream I hope will come true, that you're here with me and I'm here with you. I wish that the earth see the sky up above, will send me someone to love. Years of singing all alone turned his lover into stone, until he was on the brink of extinction. But little did he know that living in the sea below, another volcano was listening to his song. Every day she heard his tune, her lover grew and grew, because she believed his song was meant for her. Now she was so ready to meet him above the sea as he sang his song of hope for the last time. I have a dream I hope will come true, that you're here with me and I'm here with you. I wish that the earth, sea, and the sky up above will send me someone to love. Rising from the sea below stood a lovely volcano, looking all around, but she could not see him. He tried to sing to let her know that she was not there alone, but with no lover his song was all gone. He filled the sea with his tears and watched his dreams disappear as she remembered what his song meant to her.
I have a dream I hope will come true, that you're here with me and I'm here with you. I wish that the earth, sea, and the sky up above will send me someone to love.
Oh, they were so happy to finally meet above the sea. All together now, their lava grew and grew. No longer are they all alone, with aloha as their new home. And when we visit them, this is what they sing.
I have a dream I hope will come true, that you'll grow old with me
and I'll grow old with you. We thank the earth, steer the sky, we thank too.